Yes, they are. Careful, Rob. Slow down. Oh, here's
Hi, Dada.
Hi, buddy. Here's Robert on his new bike from Uncle Bruce and Aunt Deb that he got for his birthday and Christmas, and his new helmet. And there's Matthew on his older bike. We haven't broke his new one out yet. And they're riding over the ramp. And it's the 4th of January, 04.
Oh, Daddy, car!
Yeah. Watch out for the car. Mrs. Reynolds coming out of her driveway. Say hi, Matt. Oh, well, that's a nice way to say hi. Say hi, Robert. Oh, that's an interesting way to say hi, too. Well, it's been warm for the last few days. And now we're starting to get some snow. We're supposed to get a lot of it, so the boys are out here having a little fun on their bike.
Daddy!
Yeah.
Anna!
Hello. Let's see you ride down to the end and back, guys.
Okay.
No, I'm gonna film you.
Okay, Daddy.
Okay. Here's the end of our street. And there they go. Special sound effects by Robert. Good to see him having a good time. And yesterday was Penny's funeral. That was something else. Pretty sad and emotional. But here is life as it happens. Come on, guys. One over the ramp. Where's number two over the ramp? Careful, Matt.
I think I have to get that, some gas.
Oh, some gas. I see. What you doing there, Matt?
I think you should make money for the whole rest of the day.
You think you should what?
I made a mistake. Then you know what I'm doing.
Oh, well, these things happen. Yeah.
Daddy.
Yeah.
Come here.
Can you say hi nicely?
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Daddy. Dad.
Yeah.
I want to go inside.
Well, we will in a few minutes. We're going to go to Costco shortly. There's the house. The outside. And here's the backyard. This is all the new cement. There's the climber. There's the big climber. There's the two sheds. The back patio, the Razor bikes. The boys love those. They are a lot of fun. Whoop.
Sorry.
And I just got hit. Okay, guys. Put your bikes up on the porch there. Come on, Matt. Don't be so wimpy. Pick that thing up. Come on. And then put it on this kickstand. Put it over by your skateboard. That's a boy, Robert. Now put it on its kickstand. Good job. Put yours on your kickstand too, Robbie. Run around this side. It's always on the left side of the bike.
Yep.
And my hands are too cold.
Yeah, okay.
Did you take my helmet off?
Go take your helmet off and
Daddy, here, come I here. Can't.
Sure you can. You know how to do it. Mm. Come here. Say cheese. Okay, go put that in the in your box along with your knee pads. Okay, oh, Robert, come here.
Hello, Daddy.
Hello. Okay, go put that stuff away.
Looking.
Yep.
Keep looking. Follow me.
Yep, I'm following you. Whoa. Whoa, Rob, you okay?
Yeah.
Watch your step. Remember, walk ahead. Don't look at me. Come on.
Let's go, Daddy.
Put your stuff in your box.
Okay, Daddy.
Matthew, your hat goes inside. Yeah, we'll take them off.
You hold it, Daddy.
Yep.
Daddy,
give me your
toot. I'm watching the movie camera until so I do something really, really funny.
Okay. Well, take your thing off for America's Funniest Home Videos. Okay. Oh no, no, Matt, your coat goes inside. Take your knee pad off. Give me your coat. Give me your coat. Get it off the floor. Don't, Rob.
Here, Dad.
Thank you.
Hi, Daddy.
Hello. Take her off.
What next?
Okay, come on around.
Do you need that end defense too?
Nope, come on around the back door. Hey, come on, let's go.
Keep knocking, Daddy.
Yeah, around the back. And whoop, watch your step. Go on the back door. It's starting to snow. Right on. No.
Hi, Daddy.
Hi. Archie, what are you supposed to say? Hi, Uncle Bruce.
Hi, Uncle Bruce.
Hi, Aunt Deb.
Hi, Aunt Deb.
These are our new go-karts.
These are our new go-karts.
And Uncle Bruce.
Uncle Bruce.
And Aunt Deb.
What?
When you come here next time,
what?
We want to challenge you to a race on them.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay, let's see you ride them, guys.
Okay.
Bye, Dad.
Goodbye.
I'm beating you up. No, you aren't. Oh, yes, I am.
Oh yeah. So Bruce and Deb, these are called Berg pedal cars. And the model that they're driving is called a Tornado BF. And it's a single speed. You can get some that are seven speeds, but or three speeds, but this is a single speed. They're made in Holland. And they're basically indestructible. And there's Roberts and there's Matthews. And the nice thing about them is that they'll hold 350 pounds. And yes, I've driven them, and they're a gas. So, what do you think? And there's Matt's. They're both the same. They're called Tornadoes.
Well, Dad, it looks like this is the best thing I ever ridden.
What's that?
Did you see I said right in or ridden?
Ridden.
Yep.
Ridden. Say hi, Anthony.
Hi. Can
you be yours? Hi, Daddy.
Hey.
Daddy, can you be yours?
Say goodbye, Uncle Bruce.
Bye, Uncle Bruce.
Say goodbye, Aunt Deb.
Goodbye,
say, we'll see you next time.
See you next time.
And we'll have a race.
Have a race.
Say hi, Robert.
Hi.
Are you ready for today?
Yeah.
Very good.
Today is August 20th, 2004.
It's August 20th, 2004.
And today is our CAC talent show.
Today is our CAC talent show, Daddy.
Very good.
And this is the session upon it.
Yeah.
This is the session of Daddy Benny. But what we do also.
Yeah.
This.
Okay. Well, when I get started, I'll tape more, okay? Say goodbye for now.
Bye-bye.
Ready? Ready, Mama?
I'm ready, bud.
Good boy. Matthew.
And there's a going to be my...
Wow.
Oh, very nice.
My diesel. Bah, bah. Let me see which one.
It's Christmas morning, 2004, and the boys are opening up their gifts.
Wow. And look at I get.
A car carrier.
And look. Matthew, yeah. What's up?
Matthew?
Yeah?
There's two presents here with your name on them.
Oh!
Travis got his trucks. Yeah. Wow, look at that, eh, Rob?
Tic-Tac-Toe's booger! Tic-Tac-Toe's booger, exactly what I wanted!
Oh, yeah?
And yes, here's
Good morning, Mommy.
Oh, we got all these collections to have to get for Tic-Tac-Toe. Wow!
Tic-Tac-Toe!
There's a gonna be cool.
Here, I think I'll turn this off.
Wow.
Like a
month
or so. Is any more?
Just
my stocking.
This is the good booger, and I have no idea what.
What's this, Robert? Is that a new fire truck?
No. What?
Yeah.
Tonka.
A volcano train. Oh boy!
That's
wow.
A
volcano.
It's
open this.
Oh, it's a clock. How
it
cool.
It's a line up for a clock. Oh, no.
How
that
cool.
That only opens the other presents.
Well,
someone owns under the tree.
Is there? Oh.
Where am I turning my shipper?
Go turn your cars off there, Robbie.
Okay. For you also. And I bet it's closed. There's one for you. And I bet it's closed.
Oh, why don't we wait a minute here and... What'd you get, Robert? Oh, you got some books. Very nice.
That one for us. Oh, this one's for me. And
okay.
My best slime cano.
This
hey, guys.
Is for me.
Very cool. Match.
Hi, it's now Sunday afternoon. And the rest of the clan is here. Because I'm Gord Plasto.
Gord Plasto.
Mia. Mia, who has you?
I guess that was a knee, Dad. All that racket. Is there any more? Daddy, is there any more?
Robert, you need to open that for you.
What?
Don't you want to find out what you do with it, or do you know?
I have to do.
Hi, Mia.
Would you like to send
Dad? Hi, y'all.
No.
Hello. Merry Christmas. Say Merry Christmas, Rob.
Merry Christmas.
Hey, I'm taping you.
Kevin.
I'm taping you. Are you taping me? I'm taping you.
Hey, what are you doing?
I'm Peter the Fool that's taping me. Hello, Grandma. Say Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Oh, yeah. Just to prove I was here, not like Grandpa.
Hi, Grandma.
Hi, everybody. Merry Christmas.
What is that?
It's me.
CB radio.
CB radio.
Who gave you a CB radio?
Santa.
Santa?
Bah, humbug.
I was waiting for that.
That you wanted that.
Oh my gosh, the toy bomb went off again.
Usually he comes out there.
No.
Ice cream. Just kidding, Dad.
Are you lying in bed just like Brian Wilson did?
Mommy.
Excuse me.
You're excused.
Ho, ho, ho.
Hello, Robert. Where are you?
Oh. Well, be careful. Okay. Be careful.
Ready? Go in another room.
This is mine. You go.
Matt, can you bring
up
all the red
tape, please? Go in my
room. What's up, Robbie?
Hello.
Hey, who's your friend? Hey. Who's your friend?
Good. Yes, ma'am.
This is very therapeutic.
Okay, that's a good idea.
That's what they all say.
Okay.
I can hear Papa-san in Japan saying, why Papa Foley in there? He needs you.
Over.
Turn it off for me, sweetheart.
Let's say goodbye, Uncle Kevin.
Goodbye, Uncle Kevin.
5, 6.
It's Grandma's something birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Grandma. Happy birthday to you. And many more.
Okay, go stand next to Grandma.
Make my wish. Are we ready?
Yay!
Yay, Grandma!
Take a picture.
Good
Thank
job.
You.
Who would like cake and ice cream?
Me. I like chocolate only, not banana. Let me see
yours.
Chocolate or what?
Not vanilla.
Scary stuff.
No.
No. Just Rob. Looking. Just
I
looking.
Want
okay. Looking.
Where's my dog?
Go with Auntie. Let Auntie carry.
Auntie carries.
Yeah. Carry
it. Thank you, Auntie.
How many dogs do you need?
All of you. One big, two big ones, and one little one.
And you're going to remember to sit on your bottom. Sometimes it's hard to see, I know that. But if you sit up, then the people behind you can. You have to use your ears to try to look in between the people in front of you, but you still have to.
So, we're going to start, and you're going to get ready. Thank you very much. Welcome to Lunch and Reality. We hope you enjoy the show.
Thank you.
But then, ask people to jump in and play.
Number 8, show or encourage a person to learn something new like soccer or baseball.
Number 7, help a friend make a smart and cool decision. Number 6, show a student turn around school or have a great fun.
Number 5, stop
littering
in the trash can.
Number 4, clean up after yourself.
Thank you.
That's right.
Yay!
I've been looking for you everywhere. I want to thank you for teaching and playground coaches to be so caring. They have helped me so much. I hope next year I'm just as caring and helpful when I'm a playground coach.
Miss Robert!
Oh. He's got it.
There you are. My family and I have been sitting on the same island. When I told them about how it would help them with each other in a wheelchair, they were all for it. It was a great to begin.
See, Jack, you become a caring person by taking care of things.
Thank goodness we found you.
Thanks for showing how you care about Northwood students.
By volunteering your time to great school activities.
Like basketball and chess.
I can't wait to try out for the team next year.
Thank you.
Not a tripod, but at least it holds it up.
About a program that we're going to be starting very soon, very exciting, called Pennies for Playground.
Who's your friend here?
And you know his name. His name is Mars. What are you talking about?
Mars? Mars the cat. Hello, Mars.
Say hello. Say hello, huh? Are you gonna?
Where are you going there, bud? Come on.
Mars. Hi, Z. Can I try?
Mm-hmm. Through the window. Don't touch the buttons there.
Ah, there you are. Hey, I can't see.
Mm-hmm. Watch the buttons on the side.
Now, how do you take a picture?
It is. It's taking a picture now. Let me see.
There he is. Mm-hmm. What you doing? Huh? What you doing? Uh-oh. Looks like you can't reach the bottom, can you? Mm-hmm. Where'd you go? There you are. Here, Daddy.
And there he goes. Now hold it up over his head a little bit, Matt, and then wiggle it. Yeah, he's playing with it, see?
He looks like a mime.
Is he silly?
Yeah, he looks like a mime.
Mm-hmm. Matthew, look. Having fun with your kitty? Very nice. Hey, Robert. Robert and Matthew.
Oh my gosh, Bezel.
Look at Bezel.
Who's here to visit, Robert?
Bezel.
Righto. keep the dog across the street as a little Bichon Frise. I don't think he needs lunch. The dog just came home. So.
He's pretty.
Well,
just something with kids.
It kind of
yeah, he likes it, eh?
Oh, maybe you can throw it for him.
You don't want to hold him.
Matt, put the big ball back. Put the big ball back. We'll just do the little ball.
Pick it up and put it in the basket. He will poke a hole in it and he'll be sad. It won't be his fault.
Just take
Come here, Bees.
Beezle!
Gotta get his attention first, Robbie.
Beezle!
Come on in the backyard, guys.
Dude, you have this big lawn, honey.
Come on, guys. You got the big lawn. Oh. Come on in the yard, Rob. There you go.
Beezle! Beezle!
Just tell him to out it. Pull out it for you. See, out.
Out! Beezle, out!
No, out.
Out!
Good one, Robert.
Good job,
Beezle. No, he's okay. He's got chocolate
bars, so he's fine. Hey, I have to go.
No, you know what? He just eats his dog food that he's supposed to
eat. Beezle.
Mm-hmm.
All right,
Beezle.
What the? Whoa! You can have it.
Can I try?
You'll do that all
Can
day.
Can I try?
Really, really?
Beezle out.
Yeah, let Beezle
out.
Until he drops it. Beezle
out.
But our old dog that we had, she was good at fetching. And she would run and hey, Karen, Ellie, would run and run and run and run and run. And then she'd have enough.
Well, yeah, you gotta be smart, eh? Because
yeah.
They'll do anything.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Maybe he wanna bite it.
No way, Beezle says, I'm tired. I want to chew on it for a while. Hi, Nell. How are you? It's my neighbor, Nell Parent. This is Patty Kelly's brother-in-law, John Verban, and that's his dog, Beezle.
I was just curious. Hi.
Everything's fine.
No. When I saw the dog, because LeFang's got one too, right?
Who's that? Yeah, that's right. Gaston. Yeah, that's right.
And Gaston's brother's over at my house.
Oh, you're kidding,
so
really?
I said, wouldn't it be a coincidence if Gaston was here with the dog and Mark was over
right.
there?
That's right. Well, the night when they tried to get into Barb's house, remember that night? That kid? Well, he was the one who came. Robert's been talking about it all the time.
He doesn't want to play.
And I have been able to get him for VIP, so I just happened to see him today. I said, would you mind? He said, if you can, he said, no. He says, I'll try. So,
it was good.
So does Gaston's brother work with you?
Yeah,
right. Does Gaston's brother work with you?
Gaston's sister.
Oh, okay.
Mark's sister, wife. Matt.
Yeah. I got gotcha.
Yeah, they live on Kennedy.
I have a dog, and my dog is 6 years old.
I don't think.
Mine is 6 years.
Yeah. Congratulations again, then. Yeah. That's right, because I read that.
Oh,
the
nice,
Beezle.
Over there.
Can I throw it?
Next time.
I
think so. See you, Nell. Take care.
I'm going to throw it next.
Yep. See ya.
Beezle, out.
I don't know who's more thrilled, the kids or Karen. Okay, Matt, give her a throw. Good job. Honey, John lives on storage just up from Rosina and Mario. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
When we got to meet them when Karen was pregnant with Matt, she was on a lot of bed rest. And the storage girls were brought in by respite services to supply the... to supply that, and
they live at the end of the
street. Yeah, and that's how we got to meet him. Well, they're what's his name? John or Rob Durling's. Oh no! Close the door! Close the door!
Let's go.
Ooh. He doesn't need a
fun time with her.
Oh yeah, the cat would have had a fun time with you. Yikes!
He is a so sweet dog.
But Rob Durling's married to one of the daughters.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, he's married to the youngest one, Angela. Oh. Yep.
Yeah, I see. I don't know what the old guy's name is. What's his name?
Mario.
Mario?
Mario, yeah.
Hi, you have some jokes.
Yeah. Hi, Ken.
Have you not met them?
Yeah.
He'll get it.
He's probably a pretty smart puppy, eh?
Good boy, buddy. What you got?
What's in the dog? He got the ball.
Good boy.
Good for you.
He's bringing it to you. Come here, Bezo.
Look for drugs.
Bezo.
Well, he's not a drug dog, but we look for... Look for bad guys. That's what we do.
Ooh, the bad guy.
Ooh. Lizzo, come here.
Lizzo,
dog.
Really
interested in
that. And you and your dog sure
do
a good job.
Sit. Lizzo, sit. Sit.
He likes that toy.
Sit. Yeah, he likes the squeaky
Lizzo,
toy.
Lizzo, sit.
Get the ball, Robert, and throw the ball. He won't listen to you. He'll listen to Mr. John. Show him. What? Call him.
Lizzo.
That's a boy.
How do you like it out in the south?
Where did you go, Peter?
I was in South Windsor, actually, over on Kennedy.
Okay.
For the longest time.
Peter,
but the house was a little small.
Yeah.
So we moved out to La Salle about 3 years now. And it's good.
Yeah.
It's a cul-de-sac, so.
Yeah, it's a great. And you know, when you're so close to the expressway, too, you can just...
Not too far, yeah.
Yeah, that's great.
Actually, we have like a Windsor.
Yep.
All right.
Okay.
Sometimes I won't be able to use my voice. I got to use my hand, right? Here. Down.
I think that's a well-chewed on Kong.
I know it is.
Yeah, don't move, Matt.
Matt, you have to stay still so Beezy can do his job.
Beezy. Down.
You can see his whole body does this before you send him.
You know, it's like John when you march. Wait for it! See, I think I have to cut my grass.
No, it's
in
the lawn there.
He's
still quiet.
He has a police dog, so...
I know, Mom has to relax, eh? Mom has to feed to help everybody.
There it is.
Patrol dogs die, 90% of them die, they get hit by a car.
Oh, because they just focus in on the target and what you send them to, right? They don't look for danger.
You have to make sure that you can down them at any distance. That way, they cross the street with the cops, you know.
Wow!
What'd you think of that, Rob?
Yeah, that's a plan.
Rob, what'd you think of that?
Well, he's a little better because it's in competition, too. Won that
competition. Oh, that was
bad.
I mean, just in a recreation setting, eh? You got him to go down. He wanted that.
Playing the game.
Good
job.
I think he wanted to keep it, so
he keeps it. I'll get him a card. You want to take a look at the drug, too?
He's seen that enough.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll get him a card.
It's going to take him an hour to calm down. Okay. You want to go see the truck, Rob? Okay. Oh, there we are. Here's Robert training his police dog. Who's your police dog today, Robert?
His name is
Beezle. Beezle the police dog. We had a visit from Beezle the other day. And now it's Robert's turn. Yeah, it's starting to spit a little bit.
Yep.
Just to let you know, this is Robert bobbing. His tick's bothering him. There we go. Okay, policeman Robert, what are we doing here? Beezle coming back this way?
Yep.
All right. Heel.
Down. Now.
Is he a real good dog, policeman Robert?
Yes.
Is he very obedient?
He is obedient, yes. Now I'm gonna go to the club to train him instead.
Okay.
Get up, Ray. Heel. Heel.
Oh, the wind is really starting to pick up. We're supposed to get some rain. But the looks of these clouds, I think we might. It's very nice and cool out, and the humidity's gone. It's down to about 80 degrees or so.
It's starting to rain.
No, there's a little bit of thunder. No, it's actually 12 noon. And it looks like we're going to get some rain.
Let's go inside that thing.
Okay, well, let's do it as long as we can outside here. But wow, look at nature at its best, eh?
Let's go back now.
Okay.
Listen.
Daddy's motorcycle in the garage here. A lot of fun, that thing. What do you think there, policeman Robert?
Let's go inside.
Let's turn around and see the back of your shirt. What does it say on it? Las Vegas Canine Unit. Cool. Okay, Mr. Las Vegas Canine Unit, let's go in the backyard. Can you do a perimeter search of the backyard? Go back by the sheds there?
Yep.
Good job, policeman Robert. Beezle, come over to our garden. Come on. Over to our garden here. Let's see what's growing in the garden. Wow. Well, it looks like we have a big couple of big surprise pumpkin plants. Our lettuces are doing well, and our tomatoes are coming. Does Robert like tomatoes and vegetables?
No.
No? What about Beezle?
He eats dog food.
He eats dog food. Oh, okay. I see. And I think their crocus flowers are starting to come up finally.
Is there any questions?
Any questions? How old is Beezle?
I'm 9 years old.
And how old are you, Robert?
9 years old.
Oh, you're both 9 years old. Yes. Exactly. Very good. Can I see your tattoo on your arm? Your Windsor Police tattoo? How cool. Isn't that nice? Wow, the wind is really starting to come up, huh?
Let's go inside.
Okay. Let's just have a look at the clouds here. Wow. They're really coming. Our flag is really starting to blow in the breeze here. Everything's looking so green. It's been hot, but we've had our sprinkler system on. And there's our bikes back here, and there's the boys' trampoline. And here's their climber. The clothesline. And the old tractor and our back patio.
And our police bikes.
And our police bikes. There they are. Robert's blue and silver police bike and Matt's yellow and red off-road bike and Daddy's big red bike and Mummy's not so big black and yellow bike. Cool, huh?
Let's go inside to train Beezle now, okay?
You want to go inside and train Beezle?
Yeah.
And there's everything on our back deck here.
Yo.
Say, say, see you inside.
See you inside.
Okay, we're inside our house, and there's Robert with Beezle the police dog.
Heel!
Oh, good job.
Now, I'm gonna give him a treat.
Okay. Aren't the treats in your room?
No.
No? I thought you had the... Well, no, go to your room and get the treats from there. Just open your drawer.
Yeah.
Okay?
Which drawer?
Well, you know where the bowls are at. Get him a milk bone out of there.
Okay. Woo, look at
it
outside.
Oh, I know. Elaine just went outside and I got the camera on, hon.
Now, here I am.
Have you got a treat for Beezle?
And my pocket.
In your pocket? Okay.
Beezle, bark! Ah! Beezle, bark! Ah! Good job.
Mmm, that milk bone. Does Beezle like milk bones?
Yeah.
Very good. All right.
Heel! Beezle, heel! Now I'll go in my bedroom to do it.
Okay.
Ready?
Yeah, let's go.
What were you going to say, Cork? Elaine went outside.
To do up all the windows in her vehicle. Here's Robert's room. And this is where Beezle. And who's that on the bed?
This is Maverick.
Maverick is on the bed. And then who else is here? Scooby-Doo?
Yep.
And who's this little doggy here?
Jake.
Jake.
Yeah.
And who's your big doggy here, your sheepdog?
Esther.
Esther the sheepdog. That's just like the name of the Peterson's sheepdog, Esther.
Oh, yeah.
Very good.
Now, I will get... this corner on Maverick.
Mm-hmm. Very good.
And this is Maverick's and this is Beezle niches.
Yep.
Down. I say down, I say down.
Yeah.
And then I do the same thing. And then I make a report.
A police report. Very good.
Police report. This is my police computer.
Very good.
And I make this.
Yes.
And this is.
Oh, that's for. Oh, you got that poster, eh?
Yes.
There's Robert. And Officer Mike and Daddy, and there's Officer Mike police truck, and who's his dog?
Maverick.
And
this is Maverick the white dog.
That's right, and that's at the Alhambra picnic, and there's Robert, and there's Robert, and who's that? Is that Mahmood's?
No, Mrs. Awad.
Mrs. Awad, that's right, that's who's mummy?
Bahadine's
mummy, and then there's Robert with his pal Joey, and who's that girl?
One of my friends from my old school.
From Anadin, and her name is?
Brittany.
Brittany, that's right. Very good.
Now.
Okay, let's see your police computer.
Now, I gotta get some music on.
Oh, okay.
Now.
Well, we'll leave you to your music and your report writing, okay?
Yes.
And we'll check back with you later on. Say goodbye, Officer Robert.
Bye.
And thanks for showing us your police training of your dogs, okay?
Okay.
Make sure you write a good report, okay?
Okay.
All right, then. Bye-bye, bud. Wave goodbye. Well, we're at the Elgin County Train Museum, or Steam Museum, and we're here to see Thomas. It's the 23rd of January, or July, 2005. We've just come in the building, and we've given the lady our tickets, and she stamped them. And we're just inside the actual workshop. And I see a couple of boys up here who are really excited to see Thomas. Matthew! Say hi.
Hi,
Robbie.
I can't wait to see Thomas.
I can imagine. Hi, Matt. Hi, Mom.
This is a top. And it's just a top that has. See, a top with hat comes at another.
Stop, Matthew. Oh, okay. You all right?
Thank you.
Okay, yep.
Let's go.
Yep, we're going.
Ladies and gentlemen, at 11:30, they come down to the mat. Also, storytelling.
Well, hey, I got a better treat.
Yep. I'll be around here with the boys. Hi, Rob.
It's just over here on the other side. It's just back in this way.
I'm sorry. Can you get
excuse me.
Hey, look, Daddy, it's a
Mickey
Mouse.
Well, that's right. A tattoo, coloring
machine. We have that, don't we?
Yeah.
Hey, Daddy, I'm over there.
We will. We will. Look around here first. No. We're waiting for Mom. Look at Matthew. Matthew, look. London and Port Stanley Railway. Right? You've ridden on that? Hi, ladies. Very good.
Do you like your Costco membership?
We already have those.
Okay. I see the motto.
I know.
Are you up for renewal at all?
What's that?
Are you up for renewal at all?
No.
Daddy, I'm going there.
I know, we will, Matt, but look. See the train there? Sorry, ladies.
Absolutely.
That's from the London and Port Stanley Railway, which you've ridden on. I don't know where this one's from, but it looks like they just all painted it up. What does it say on it? Come here, Rob. Oh, there it is. CP Rail. It's a CP Rail locomotive.
What did they do here?
It looks like they just painted it. Look over here, Matt. Pullman car, New York Central Pullman car.
Oh my gosh, look at that small train!
Yeah.
What's that Thomas train?
Well, it looks like a Thomas train, but I don't know what it is.
Well, it's not.
Hi, Thomas.
No, it's not a Thomas train, Dad, but what is it from?
I don't know, but it's got a sign on the front of it, doesn't it? Yeah. Well, let's wait for Mom. Mom will be right back.
Why is she here?
Imagination station where you can do some coloring if you want to.
Okay, well, I thought there was some other trains here.
Come here.
I thought there was some other trains here.
Yeah? Over this way. It's September 9th, and this is Karen and our dog Cinder, who I can't see. Not yet. And Cinder is 10 weeks old. There she is, and Karen's putting her new collar on. And there's Matt out there in the swing. Say hi, Matt. And there is Robert hugging the camera.
Let's do our
silly boy.
Ready? Good sit. Good sit. Ready, Cinder? Down. Down. Boy, down. Good girl. Cinder, sit. Oh. Sit. Good sit. Stay. Sit. Stay. Sit.
Robbie, you'll confuse her. Come and sit over here with me. Let Mommy do this.
Sit or come. Good girl. That's a girl. Stay.
Good girl. Okay. Dad, mm-hmm. After Karen's dog, can I do something too?
After who?
After Karen.
Who is Karen?
Mom.
Yeah, that's better, please. Mom.
Well, after Mom, can I do something with you?
Well, we're just going to spend some time out here in the backyard, Rob.
Hi, Dad.
Hello.
Cinder. Cinder.
She's got the evening crazies, just like mm-hmm. the kitty.
Mm-hmm.
You're gonna go through the bushes.
Tunnel! Come here! Come here! Come here! Good
set! Here she goes! There she goes, girl. Come on. She weaves in and out of the hedges. I wanna
go here.
You're a crazy thing. Hi.
Where are you? Is that you? There you are.
Where's Squeaky? Where's Squeaky? Where's your Squeaky? Hey, baby girl. Cinder. Where's your mom? Are you ready? Are you ready? Cinder, come.
It's that little electric
good
car,
sit.
Isn't it?
Ready? Woo! Go get it!
I did it.
Here's the boys' trampoline.
Yeah.
And that's their climber. The sheds in the back
Cinder.
Deck, and the bikes in the cage.
Cinder.
In the garden.
Cinder, give it. Rob, go dead and throw it. Come here, girl. Come
very
here.
Good.
Come here, Cindy.
Oh.
Sorry.
You gotta be careful, Matt. You okay, Cinder? Oh, that means she was hurt, Matt. It's now about 2:45 on Wednesday, the 21st of December, and this is outside of Holy Names High School right now. This is where the traffic jam sort of starts. And if you look up the street, you'll see the buses down in front of Northwood School. There's not enough parking for the buses in front of the school. Traffic up Dominion. I have 2:51 in my watch. It's 10 minutes till school gets out, and this is Dominion at this, or Longfellow at this particular time. You can see there's no parking left. The parents are already starting to stack in the driveway. There's no parking here. I'll have to see if I can squeeze into a spot. I have to come down here to pick up Robert. These are teacher cars over here. I'll have to park over here. There's room and there's room. And if you look up the street, I haven't even passed by a minute, and the driveway is already started to fill. Hello, sir. Yeah, I think so. I just want to do some videotaping. I've always wanted to do this, but I never have, so now I am. Ah, terrific. Thank you very much. Can I keep that? Okay, Robert, we'll be happy. I'll talk to you in a bit, Kev. Thank you. I'm going to come up over here. These cars here are all parent cars. This is how early they have to get here to ensure that they can get a spot to pick their child up. That's why it's pretty important for us to have a kiss and ride. It's now, I've got about 7 minutes to. There are a couple of parking spots that the parents haven't taken. And there are cars stacked up in the driveway here. And there are signs up that say no parking between 2:45 and 3:15 for parents to pick up their children. And these are all parent cars that are in there. The school staff and the school visitors are very good about obeying the signs, and they do leave. And now they're starting to stack. There aren't any no parking signs and no stopping signs around here, and even if they were up, they would be disobeyed. These are the parents trying to do the best under this situation to pick up their children. Okay, I've got, looks like about 6 minutes to three on my watch. And this is the bus zone in front of the school. Now, there's not enough room in the bus lane for the buses, so this is what they have to make do with to pick up the kids. Probably I'd appreciate that we would lose a couple of buses, because the kids won't be coming here from the area of sort of the back end of Remington Park, Slater Street in that area, to get to school here, but there's going to be that many more kids going to Roseland. So they'll probably have a problem accommodating their buses. Now, this is the traffic that's starting to collect here. As you can see, people that aren't going into the school have to sort of dodge around and fit between the cars. Like I said, there are no parking signs here, but it wouldn't matter anyways. The parents have nowhere to park when they come to get their children, so this is what's happening here. You can see it or not, there's a vehicle southbound that's going to try to make it through cars. There's another one back there. Dominion gets so busy that people try to use Longfellow as an alternative, and it is, can be somewhat quicker, except for around this time of the day. Shows a little bit of the backup that occurs at Northwood and Dominion, with sort of the rush hour traffic and the high school getting out and Northwood School about to get out. On the watch here, it's about 2 minutes to three. Our school should be getting out shortly. There's more cars stacking, the vehicle stacking on the road here. See up the way here. Okay. As you can now see, the driveway is full. There is sort of a center laneway in the driveway that is open, but it has to be kept open so that people, once they get their kids, can get out, so that people waiting to get their kids can get in. I don't know if this is going to work or not, but if you look way up the street, I think I'm catching it. You can see the cars stacking way up down there. Some of the parents up there waiting for their children. Here. Jam of cars in the road here, which will eventually get worse, I have no doubt. Filming. Okay, now the bell is gone and the students are starting to leave. Yep, poor Mrs. Murray is helping us out at the school and the parents by guiding children to their cars.
I'm so glad somebody's doing that.
Thank you. See you.
Now one car is coming out.
Another car is starting to come. And then the problem that we have is people exiting, especially those turning left.
Why are you gonna do this?
So the people can see it. Matthew!
Pharaoh, take me, Daddy!
No, not this time. Okay?
Now this car is...
Just showing all the problems with parking here. And traffic. Now parents are exiting. Sorry, I'm not a videographer. I think we get the general idea here.
Can I show Matthew something?
Yep, sure you can.
Dad.
Whoa!
Who's that?
Easel.
Yes! No mic. Can I put it back in?
Yeah. Okay. There's somebody taking the high side to try to get around.
Look at snow on the left. Look at snow on there.
Exiting.
Big bunch.
Rob.
Don't, please.
How do you? Daddy, what time is it? Where is that, Mr. Willoughby? Yeah.
I don't know. Thank you.
Oh, man! You need to come across, Spencer. I have my car.
Oh, here. It's fine. It's perfect. Very good. All right, here we are, just backing out because it's jammed.
Yeah, hello.
Wow, that was interesting.
That is it.
Okay.
Architecture.
Yeah. How are you?
Grandpa!
Hi. photographer?
Yes.
Video game.
Yeah.
So.
What are you doing? What are you doing?
Well, we just finished eating.
We had a wonderful dinner.
Excellent. Yes.
Yes. Okay. See you later.
Bye.
Hey, Hazel. Hey, hi.
How you doing?
Hi.
Hi.
Yes,
do you, baby? Huh? Look at that leg.
But yeah, she's been down a few
times. Hi, Cinder.
We thought that probably
she's naked.
She's here.
You're like,
seems
to be in
drawers.
You naked? Hi.
Oh, you've got your camera.
Cinder. Hi, girl. Cinder.
Oh,
Cinder.
Before she was sitting there beside me.
Oh yeah.
All of that. Okay. Just sat there and.
Hi, Mom.
She was a spoiled one. Last night when we got the girl towel, she could just boom up onto the bed, whatever she wanted.
Hey.
Finally, when it was time to go to bed, Jim he lay down and he said, "Come on, jump up in the bed." Well, she's this
Hi,
way, and
boy.
Then she's this way. Do you think she'd jump up there?
Hey.
Like I'm tired. She looked at me like, "Pick me up." She couldn't get up. I had to pick her up. Kind of small.
Now he's going to my room. Going over here. Who is over here? It's Grandpa.
Hi, guy.
Hey, what are you guys watching?
Careful where you're walking.
Anyway, I go down there and I quit.
Oh, golf, okay.
Yeah, my dad's going
to be better. Now we go over to here. There's nothing over here. What is over here?
Ooh.
Hello, Daddy.
Work right there.
Yeah.
Yes.
Say hello.
Hi.
Filming.
Hi.
How are you?
How are you, sir?
Yeah.
Hi, Robert.
And this is Robbie's room.
Oh, this is Robert's room.
And Robbie likes dogs.
Dogs and police.
Hi, Caesar.
Up.
You got a nice room.
Hi.
Nice. Yeah.
Hi.
When Robbie goes, oops, sorry, honey. When Robbie
Very
goes
nice.
To camp, he has this blanket that's all been hand done by Debbie. And
oh, really?
Yeah, and yeah. And uh-huh. It's the rough and tough and bubble
yeah.
kind of
yeah.
thing.
Yeah.
Robert.
Yeah.
Yep.
Hey, sweetheart.
And it's got where is it here? It's got
you got a
dog zone.
This right?
Oh yeah.
Closet.
Like there's the
oh, isn't that neat?
Oh,
for Robert.
Yeah.
She is
yeah,
so talented.
Oh, she sure is.
Yeah, on this side here.
It's
yeah.
supposed to be the patchy.
It's got Robert's.
Isn't that yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nice.
Oh, she does wonderful
she sure does.
Work.
Isn't that this cool? is your sister, right?
My sister-in-law.
Oh, sister-in-law.
Yeah.
Okay.
Jordan
yeah.
has one sibling.
My brother's
oh, oh, I see. Just
yeah.
the two boys in it.
Yeah.
Oh, I love
that's enough of us.
That's enough.
No, we're talking about the boys.
This is my Hagel study.
Yeah, those dogs
right?
are pretty.
I know it.
Because I'm going to walk out later
and
on, forget
Tigger,
it, and I'll be in
and Pooh,
one hall,
yeah.
and I go,
man. Yeah, and that
yeah.
isn't that Piglet
sister
right there, that Piglet?
You owe me money, right? I don't
know. Very nice. Just
all.
Very, very nice.
Look at all the clothes. Now we go over here to all the people, okay?
That's what they were telling me.
Hi, Daddy.
Hello, Robbie. What are you doing?
Good. What are you doing?
Look at that stuff on the computer. I just saw pictures on it.
Okay. I don't know, okay?
Okay.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Here's the dog.
Cinder.
It's a little girl.
Cinder. Hi, Cinder again. What are you doing? What are you doing?
Great shot, eh?
Yeah.
And they're on track.
Yeah, and they have a
for the
high scoring final
round
in this tournament history.
That's amazing, eh?
At 75.6.
Oh,
isn't that something?
What's the pup's name, Robert?
Her name is Cinder.
Cinder.
Cinder. That looks like our Cinder in Michigan.
Look at the tail, whip everything
that's
up.
That's it. Hold up. Dust mop.
Cinder.
Dust mop.
What can you do, Cinderella, Cinderella? What can
she?
I don't know. I have to ask my dad, mom, or dad. So I have to ask my dad right now.
Not so loud, Rob.
How old are you?
That's a good question.
Mom? Mom?
8 months. What's going on out here, guys? Oh my gosh, you don't see this much anymore. When's the last time you seen one of these?
This is,
What did you say?
Oh,
okay, on the table.
Mm-mm. Guys, can I have a t-shirt now or no? Can I have a t-shirt now?
Yes, I think.
Oh.
Wow.
Wow.
Dad, can I turn it off and I can do it after I have my t-shirt? Are you okay?
What's that?
After I have dessert, so.
Yeah. After you have dessert, what do you want to do?
I'm going to try to take some off.
Yeah.
I am easy.
I use that in my country because it has freedom, like freedom of speech, and I can go anywhere I want in my country. I respect Canada, the country I live in, because it's safe. I respect this country because it has peace, not wars and violence. Now we would like to pause for a moment of silence for all of you to think about how you respect your country. Welcome to CBC News. Today we are talking about people in the community even forgetting that we do respect, like the firefighters and police officers. Today we're going to interview one firefighter and two police officers. Take it from him, Mike. Officer Rebecca, how do you take care of the police dogs?
We treat our dogs like a part of our family. We treat them every day.
Now, back to Jeremy. Why it is important to respect people in your community. After the break, we'll talk about the wedding.
They will always be there for you. Your parents need respect.
Now is the right time to start. You should not have any regrets. When you're apart, they're still in your heart.
Everybody wants it, everybody wants it. Heather's girlfriend.
Lori has a nice one. You don't usually see it, but like when her shirt goes up or something.
Yeah, a lot of the young girls have
it. Hi, guys. Miss and Terry.
Yes, dear. On the back. Yeah, Rachel has one. I almost flipped one.
Can you hear me?
Yes. Back in the summer
I can hear you. How come the light is flashing?
The battery almost had 200 right there.
I jacked it again when I put it on.
Yeah,
when I was in Australia,
Susan
says,
"Oh,
you should put it on and go home."
Go home.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, it's interesting because Heather's one of her friends. Her mom is a nurse, and she works. The couple that she works for are two doctors, a husband.
Oh, this one, this
I don't
like.
Think I want to be surprised all the time.
No.
Oh man, has he ever got that whacked out focus? Where's the focus?
No, we want to be able to tell you.
There, that's right. That's right. What's different, and then I realized
hey, Robbie.
What was different because it was.
Hey, Robert.
You know, they,
hey.
They
say hi.
Good.
You have to have
good. How's school going?
Good.
Good.
What are you doing?
Right now, I'm recording you, even though I can't really see you. You look like fuzzy. Are you fuzzy?
No.
No? You're not fuzzy? Well, let me see if everybody else is fuzzy. Oh, yeah. Everybody's fuzzy. I cannot see anybody.
Well, I called Karen yesterday.
Why not? You can see me.
Well, I can see sort of a shadow of you. But you're fuzzy. Alrighty. You're not moving. You're not talking to me.
Oh, did you forget? I was watching a show called How It's Made, and I like that show.
That's a very interesting show, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. What are they making right now?
They're making candies.
What kind of candies?
Worms.
What kind?
Worms.
Oh, the worm ones. Oh, yeah.
So, what are you going
to
do anyway?
I don't know right now. I'm just sort of holding the camera, looking at somebody that's fuzzy. Okay, that's the, okay.
Too loud.